Hey guys, this is Götz from Behringer. In this video, I wanted to talk to you about our modular or semi-modular synth. We call them semi-modular because, well, it's a fully fledged synth. Everything you need to make great sounds, plus it has MIDI and USB, but they are semi-modular, meaning you can do internal connections with the cable, or you can combine these with, for example, third-party modules. How about you would add a third or fourth oscillator to your synth, or you could add a sequencer. And these follow the Eurorack format, so meaning you can take them out and put them with your modules into a rack. And this is what came today from our factory. I haven't opened it yet. I thought we'll do it together. Check out the new Eurorack Go, which is a huge, huge Eurorack case for these synths and also these modules. Figure out how the power supply and everything works. And in the end of the video, I can give you a sneak peek on some very, very interesting upcoming stuff. Okay, let's make some room. So we get a handbook, we get a sticker, it's like with an Apple product. Really beefy power supply. And here's the main event. So, as you can see, we have two rows for modules. These will fit, of course, anything that's Eurorack. We'll put a Model D in later. The bus board, this will distribute all the power to the modules. Every module has, and maybe you've seen this when you unboxed your Model D, for example, they all have these small ribbon cables included, so you can hook this up to the power supply. There's a power connector, there's a DC input for the power supply, there's a hand grip. There seems to be, and I didn't know this, there's a stand, which is kind of cool. Put it up like this, or use it more as a tabletop, which is kind of cool. Okay, so let's build something. You always have to be a bit careful when you take these out the first time, because they have a connection to the board on the inside. And this you have to unplug carefully. So to explain quickly how the power supply in a Eurorack works, you have these connectors. These connectors have ground and multiple voltages on them. And what's special about this case is we have three zones. They're called A, B, and C. And every zone can supply up to 1 amp of power to our synth, to our modules. Now you might think, well, oh, that's complicated. How do I figure out how much power one of these modules need? Well, there's a great website called Modular Grid. And Modular Grid has basically more than 5,000 compatible Eurorack modules. You can combine and configure your own individual Eurorack simply by drag and drop. And then there's a button, and this button will output the power that these modules need. So with this, you can easily calculate how much power you need. Now your modular synth has the ribbon cable for the power included. Don't be scared, you can only plug this in into the correct orientation, and the same goes for the bus board as well. There will be a lot of stuff to edit out later. I can delete hours on hours of footage. Okay, so that's in. Now let's get some modules. The question is, of course, can I put in a second Model D? Let's try a sequencer. And let's try a quantizer. Now, one of the most famous modular synthesizers was, of course, the Moog modular, which was used by very famous artists in very, very famous songs. You can hear it, for example, on the intro of the TV series Stranger Things. This is a Moog modular. And I promise you a sneak peek. Well, we'll have some upcoming Eurorack modules. Okay, schnell, schnell, we need power. Does it work? Yeah, cool. OK, Okay, guys, let's make some music.